Tiberias. 20 and a half years of bloodshed. We are far from the ocean, so the citizens interpret the smell of salt and commotion of sea birds as signs from heaven. I sit near Saladin's tent, watching the butchery below. Citizen horse archers sweep through yet another unorganized mob of European soldiers. The great crusader nations have been reduced to puny city-states. Only Tiberias, Tyre, and Ascalon are still in crusader hands. Nonetheless, these three cities are well fortified and could withstand any siege. Saladin has had many victories on the open desert, but the crusader castles are unparalleled. If he is victorious now, the Holy Land will belong to the Saracens again. A failure could mean decades more of carnage.
Thank you. Naor. Amron. Benaor.
Yeah!
Yeah. Thank you. حسنا سأفعل.
Hasan.
سأفعل نعم
سأفعل
هجوم
Thank you.
سأفعل.
Oh,
Now.
Lord Saladin, we are weary of this senseless bloodshed. Tribute to us 1,000 gold as a show of good faith, and we will call a truce.
Hassan.
القتال القتال هجوم نعم
الهجوم
نعم حسنا نعم
I'm not going to do that.
أستاذ القتال الهجوم
سأفعل
نعم سأفعل سأفعل الهجوم
نعم سأفعل هجوم
حسنا سأفعل نعم هجوم
حسنا نعم حسنا
Hassan, Safa.
Once I was amazed at the nobility of the Saracen warriors. Only a few years ago, they entered battle as gentlemen, bringing with them treasure chests, wine, singing girls, and collections of doves, nightingales, and parrots. No longer. In reaction to European hostility and fanaticism, the Saracens have steadily become more resolute, more bloodthirsty. Their love of art is replaced by a love for battle. Now, in answer to the Crusade, they have adapted their principle of jihad for warfare. The result has been devastating to the Crusaders. The European presence in the Holy Land was finished, or so everyone believed.